Hello students, in my last class you have studied about telegraph. So today our topic is printing press. Now in this, here you can see the picture of printing press. Now the how it invented, we have to learn that. Before the invention of the printing press, the Chinese used blocks to print books. And they would carve designs or the desired symbols on a block of wood, apply it into the carved side and press it hard on the paper. And the paper would get an impression of the symbol. Means that the Chinese, they used the block prints to print the books, and with that they carved designs or the desired symbols, and it was applied into the carved side and press it on the paper. But this method was time consuming. It takes lots of time. So it would take too long to print several copies of a book. So in 1450, Johannes Gutenberg invented the first usable printing machine. You can see here the picture of Johannes Gutenberg with his printing press. And how it was done? It was done by the using wooden blocks. Metal letters could be more useful for printing. Means for Chinese, they used the wooden blocks, but Gutenberg, he used what? Metal letters for printing. Because the metal molds of letter were very less times to print, and he arranged movable molds of letters to form words, lines and a full page. And this type of page is called typesetting. And a typist page would be smeared with ink and pressed on a sheet of paper. And the impression of text would be transferred to the paper. So in this way the printing press works. So after printing one book, the metal molds would be dismantled and used to print another book. When another book wants to print, then the metal molds, it is dismantled, and then after dismantling, the another book was printed. And many copies of a book could be made easily, since metal molds could be reused, and it made printing of books cheaper, and it is cheaper also. And more people could now afford to buy and read books because it is cheaper. Now the next communication what we are using today are that computers and Internet. Now all of you know the use of computer. Computers and the internet or World Wide Web have totally changed the way of communication, and it help run our business efficiently. And what are the uses of computers that you know very well, because you are learning from the first standard itself, that computers perform calculation in seconds. And they were used as monitors in aircrafts, ships and cars to find geographical position, fuel usage and engine temperature. And there are two kinds of personal computer, that is desktop and laptop. Now desktop, see here, this is all you know that how desktop is. Desktop are installed at homes and offices, because it is fixed in a place only. And laptops are portable and easy to handle. They can be carried and used anywhere at any time, as it is small to carry. And the internet is a worldwide network of computers, and through it we receive new information on different topics and issues. And through it we can send and receive electronic mail, that is email, to and from any part of the world. and using a search engine on the internet we can find out information about anything. That computer is a very fast electronic media. Now our next topic is satellites. And what is satellite? A satellite revolves around a planet. And there are natural and man-made satellites. And the man-made or the artificial satellites orbit the Earth and help. And how they help? They help to predict the weather and track hurricanes. Hurricanes means it's a type of typhoon and all. And second one, understand space and the other heavenly bodies. And there are some satellites which are used mainly for communication, such as beaming TV signals and phone calls around the world. All the TV signals we are getting from the satellite only. And before satellites, TV signals didn't reach far. And they would trail off into space instead of following the Earth's curves, as TV signals travel in a straight line. And here is a picture of communication satellite. And setting of telephone wires over long distance or underwater was difficult and very expensive. So, with the help of satellites, these TV signals and phone calls are sent upward to satellite. And these signals are sent back at different locations on the Earth. And today we are able to watch live shows and other programs on television with the help of this communication satellite only. And these satellites receive signals from the television station on the Earth. The station on the Earth receives these signals and transmits them further to television sets in the form of pictures. What pictures we are getting in the television, it is because of the communication satellite only. And without these communication satellites, it would not have been possible to view live programs. Students, you have seen many live programs, as the cricket match and other things also we can see in programs. So it is because of the communication satellite only. So here we have finished our chapter. So in my next class, I will give you the question answers. Thank you.